That chutney has layers of flavor.
Yes, yes man. Cheers for the Gunduri.
Cheers. Oh my goodness. I don't even need to exert any effort. This idli is so soft. It's just breaking away just by the effect of gravity. That's how soft this idli is.
We are in high-tech city Hyderabad and we are here to do a breakfast Andhra style. And to help us navigate through this very traditional Andhra breakfast, I have a very special guest with us on this episode of Gourmet on the Road. So let's go meet him and taste a typical traditional Andhra breakfast. Let's go. Hi, Hello, Ravi.
Hi, how are you doing?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm very good.
So Ravitej Ravuri runs a exceedingly successful YouTube channel called Streetbyte, and you've been doing this for the last 3 or 4 years.
4 years.
4 years. And what I really like, Ravi, is the sincerity and honesty with which you approach food. And so when Ravi reached out to us as we were doing our research on Hyderabad, mentioning he would be happy to collaborate, we were extremely happy to, and that's what brings us here to Hyderabad to meet Ravi and
eat breakfast at chutneys.
And eat breakfast at chutneys.
Breakfast with a lot of chutneys.
Breakfast with a lot of chutneys because we are at chutneys.
It's not like, you know, you get only one coconut chutney or one peanut chutney. You have a bunch of them. You need to try everything. And let us get into the kitchen first and let us see how the 70mm dosa is made.
What is a 70mm dosa?
70mm dosa is not a screen, but it's a 3 feet long dosa. So they're gonna make the biggest dosa, like, you know, they mix like 2 to 3 dosas and they make the biggest dosa with which is like 3 feet long.
So and the 70mm dosa, Hyderabad loves its films. Tollywood is one of the biggest film industries in the world. So, but naturally they had to have a 70mm dosa. So let's go in and taste a traditional Andhra style breakfast.
So here's Mr. Sairam.
Nice to meet you.
So he's gonna show us the kitchen.
Let's go. Let's go into the kitchen and watch that 70mm dosa being prepared. It's only fitting that the 70mm dosa is made on a 70mm pan. So this is the biggest dosa in Hyderabad. In Hyderabad, is it dosa or dosa?
Dosa.
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 Dosa. How big is this? How many feet?
4 feet.
I'm told that this dosa is 4 feet. There's a generous amount of ghee and oil that's being slathered on this dosa. So now the dosa is coming away from the pan. It's ready to be rolled into that 70mm offering that is served on a plate. So there you go, we have the biggest dosa here in Hyderabad, the 70mm dosa, right here at Chutneys.
So this is the dosa, this is the masala for you.
Okay.
And then you got like 3 chutneys here. This is coconut peanut chutney. And this is the star.
Pure plain coconut chutney.
With sweet.
With sweet?
Yes. So generally, this is a kind of coconut sweet we make at home.
Okay.
So, but with jaggery.
Ah.
But with jaggery, okay. So this is putnal chutney. This is called putnal. Putnal matlab all the dals.
So this is a putnal chutney, putnal which chutney. Is with all the lentils.
Lentils, yeah. And coming to this, this is ginger chutney, which is made with jaggery in it.
Ah. So it's got that lush, velvety sort of a texture. Yeah.
Basically, if you go to any place in Andhra and Telangana, this is the common chutney used. They call allam bellam.
Allam bellam.
Bellam matlab jaggery.
Jaggery.
And this is also a ginger chutney, but this is made with green chilies and kind of pudina.
So that's a spicy one.
Yeah, it's a kind of spicy one. And this is tomato and corn.
Tomato and corn.
Corn, yeah.
Wow.
You see the texture of this?
I can make out it's thick. It's thick.
You get a lot of flavors in this.
Lovely. So you have to have it with all the chutneys.
All the chutneys.
This is the masala, the potatoes.
So potatoes, onions, some curry leaves.
Yes.
What do you call the masala? You call it just masala.
If it is given the same texture in rice, it will be called talimpo.
Talimpo.
Yeah, fry.
Fry.
Okay, but this is a masala that we get in Andhra and Telangana for masala dosa. Not dosa, dosa.
Dosa, that's right. Yeah, dosa. So please, viewers in Karnataka, I'm in Hyderabad, so it is dosa here. Dosa. So that's why I will liberally use dosa, because I get lynched otherwise when I say dosa. So my first taste of this 70mm dosa here. Cheers. He's gone for the chutney right away like a pro. But you know, I like to taste my dosa first just by itself. Just taste. This is a dosa that certainly has some body. It's a thick dosa.
Thick dosa, yeah.
So when you look at it while it's being fried, you think it's going to be paper thin.
Yeah, very thin, but it's not. It's not actually.
I also like the tartness of that batter. I think they keep the batter for some time to rise, for the batter to ferment. Yeah, I love the grainy texture of the dosa. So as you bite into it, so it's probably also the lentils that have gone into it.
Yes.
So it has that grainy texture. Let's now taste with the chutney. So we're going to start first with the coconut and peanut chutney.
Very subtle. It will be very happy. The flavors are very happy actually.
But it also has some spice. You can taste that.
Then you should try the peanut chutney.
But there is some chili in this, right?
Yeah. Very little.
Is that little?
Yeah.
But you know, I like the flavor. It's a sort of chutney, so although I can feel it a little spicy, but it's a sort of chutney that makes you want to go back for a second bite.
Yes, absolutely.
Next, we're going to go for the
putnal.
The putnal or the lentil chutney. I like the creamy color of it. It's almost like a light pista color. There's also a certain sourness that I get in the chutney.
Yes.
So is that from?
So basically, if it is an Andhra this thing, what they do for every chutney, every chutney, they add a little bit of tamarind to it.
A little bit of tamarind.
A little bit of tamarind for everything.
Okay.
Except the curries.
Okay.
It is a vegetarian thing. It is a pulusu. They call it pulusu.
Pulusu, of course.
If it's a pulusu, they go for tamarind. If it's chutney, they go for tamarind. A little bit of tamarind everywhere.
So Andhra loves its tamarind.
Yes.
And the chili, of course.
Yes. And now you're going to feel
the mirupukai, the green chili.
Pachimichi.
Pachimichi.
Pachi matlab, which is greenish.
Greenish. And michi is mirchi.
Michi is michi.
All right. You know, what I think is interesting here, Ravi, is the fact that you got all these chutneys with the dosa. You know, you can actually mix and match. So it kind of, although it's such a big dosa, it's actually very interesting because every time you're putting a different chutney in your mouth, you're tasting something different. Let's taste some tomato corn chutney with this 70mm dosa. You know, that chutney has that sour edge of the tomato. And that corn just provides that textural pop. So you're tasting the dosa, you're tasting the sourness of the chutney, and then you have that pop of that corn.
Now that's going to be spicy, the next one.
Yes. Green chili and ginger chutney. Ravi warns me. He says it's going to be a spicy one and he's going to be watching my expressions. So I'm going to do my best to keep a calm composure, even though I'm burning inside.
And by seeing the color, you thought like it would be spicy, but it's not.
You know, the chili in this is very mellow. It's like just that warm heat that, you know, coats your palate. You know, I quite like this, in fact. It's quite a chatpata chutney. That chutney has layers of flavor.
Yes. And the next one, you'll have a sweetness, a spice, a sourness. You have different flavors now.
The Allam Bellam chutney. That's a strong chutney.
Yes. And now this is spicy?
It's got spice, but I wouldn't really say it's spicy. It's a sort of chutney that just takes over your palate. I think if you taste this chutney first, you will not taste anything else.
Yes, that is like a bit last.
So there is a way to eat these chutneys here at Chutneys. This is a nice thick sambar. You can see all the goodness of the lentils. Yeah. You know, this is very simple in its flavors.
Yes.
You just taste the lentils and perhaps the edge of the tamarind.
Yes.
So it's got nothing to distract you, right? So there's no vegetables, there's no drumstick, no brinjal. You just taste the sambar just as it is.
Now you need to taste this.
So this is just fresh coconut and sugar.
Sugar.
In Karnataka, there is a dosa that's made, which is then stuffed with coconut, a little bit of sugar. So that's the sort of flavor that I get. So it's that coconut milk, right? This is what you taste. That is deliciousness in a bite.
Babai Idli. So this is a white butter. So this is Guntur Idli.
The Guntur Idli.
Yeah.
Okay. And I can see that's red and spicy. Guntur chili.
Guntur chili, yeah.
So that is a coconut peanut chutney. This is a lentil chutney. Oh my goodness. I don't even need to exert any effort. This idli is so soft. It's just breaking away just by the effect of gravity. That's how soft this idli is. I can taste that white butter, and because of the heat of the idli, that butter is now giving a ghee flavor.
Ghee flavor, and then the idli actually absorbs the whole butter.
Wow, this idli is soft. It's difficult to hold this idli and bring this together in one bite. It's crumbling away. I think there's no way you can take the idli to the chutney. You have to take the chutney to the idli.
Because it's dipped completely with the butter.
So we're going to just smear a bit of the chutney on the idli.
Yeah.
And try delicately to get it in one mouthful. Let's go. You know that I love my idlis. And this idli is perhaps one of the best out there.
Now, it's time for you to taste the Guntur Idli.
You know, I love how soft this idli is.
You need to break it like this.
You know, just look at this.
Yes.
It breaks under his own weight. That's how soft and fluffy this idli
is.
Cheers,
man. Cheers for the Guntur Idli.
Cheers. So you can definitely taste that podi.
So
I think
satisfying.
It's also opening up your sinuses.
Yes. Yes.
Yeah, I'm going to taste it with that chutney now. I think that podi is aggressive. So for me personally, I want some of that chutney just to help tame its aggression. I feel the flavors now are more rounder.
Yes.
You know, I think what's interesting here at chutneys is the fact that even if you order, let's say, a single portion of a dish, the fact that you have six chutneys,
yes,
it's almost like you're tasting six different things.
Plus sambar,
right? Yeah. For some of the Guntur Idli with the lentil chutney.
I will definitely recommend you to cover the Babai Idli.
With the sambar.
This is completely different, not the Tamil Nadu Karnataka style. But
so some idli with the sambar. The Andhra style sambar, which is nice and lusciously thick. It's very comforting.
Comfortable, yeah.
Right? So break that Babai Idli down, mix it well, get a nice mouthful into your hands and transfer all its contents safely to your mouth. That's a look of happiness. You've got the softness, the crumbly softness of the idli, you've got that creamy flavor of the ghee, and then you've got that comforting taste of the sambar.
So you know the sugarcane juice?
Yes.
So that's used for making jaggery, right?
Correct.
So while making, in process, they take this syrup.
Oh, it's almost like honey.
So this is sourced before making jaggery.
What is it called?
It's called cheruku, cheruku matam sugarcane.
Okay.
Sugarcane, cheruku panakam.
Panakam.
This is a syrup.
And this is the Chiranjeevi Dosa.
Yeah. So why is it called Chiranjeevi Dosa? So basically whoever visits Chiranjeevi's place.
Okay.
So, at his home, this is very famous, you know, all the guests who go there love to have the set dosa of Chiranjeevi. This is MLA Pesarattu.
The MLA Pesarattu.
So, which is made with the green gram.
Okay.
It has some beauty inside it.
Oh, it is stuffed with an upma of sorts.
Yeah. Then you have this onions. And then on top of it, butter anyway.
Butter goes without saying, I think.
Yeah. And this is mango uthappam.
So this has the raw mango paste with spices that's spread on.
Spread over the uthappam.
Ah.
Check this out. You see this side, it's very soft.
That's true.
Okay, this is all soft like a uthappam. But when you see this, it's very dry, very hard.
That's the raw mango paste that's smeared on top. So what should we start with? I think we should start with the
Chiranjeevi dosa. Yes.
With some cheruku panakum. I'm going to go for this right here. I'm going to be a little greedy. Oh, dosa is a thick dosa.
Yes, it's a steam dosa.
So there is not a drop of oil that goes into the making of this dosa.
Yes.
So it has that spongy texture
of dosa
that has soaked all that
cheruku panakam,
and then the dosa has a crunch at the bottom.
Yes, absolutely. Now you see this.
I think I'm going to, when in Rome, do as the Romans do. When in Hyderabad, do as Ravi does.
Great.
And we're going to drench this Chiranjeevi dosa too in all that cheruku panakam. That's given me a sugary sweet high. So the flavor of the cheruku panakam is quite interesting. So it has the consistency of honey, but the sweetness is more aggressive than that of honey. With honey, you will probably find a slight bitter edge, but this cheruku panakam is sweet all the way through. Picturize sugarcane and then jaggery, and this is somewhere in between, and that's really the liquid that goes into making jaggery.
Yes.
I love the sponginess of this dosa and that crisp edge. It's soft.
Yes.
It's pillowy soft. It's like a pillow. You can sleep on this. You can rest your head on this.
Take a piece of pesto.
So this is made, typical pesto rattu made with green gram.
Yes.
Is something smeared? This is just a normal pesto rattu, right?
This is normal pesto rattu.
Okay.
And now, take the buttery, oily, and a lot of ghee, upma. And then the onion, and then have it.
All right. So here's a pesto rattu and I'm going to go for a greedy dollop of that upma, and I'm also going to steal a curry leaf.
Yes. How's it?
Sometimes you don't need words.
Yes, yes, absolutely. And now see, there is a bit of cashew. This is upma, okay, and then a bit of carrot. And then onion, you have onion, you have curry leaf, and then green chili.
So that's a perfect bite of this MLA pesto rattu. I love that. I love that grainy crunch of the pesto rattu.
Yes.
And then that softness, the lush softness of the upma, which is punctuated only by that fresh crunch of the onions. This is such an interesting and cleverly constructed dish.
Yes. So now this is mango uthappam.
Oh, thank you so much. I think we should share this.
Yeah.
This is the uthappam with the raw mango paste smeared on top.
Yes. You have the tanginess coming out.
That's right.
Yes, at the end.
You can see those slivers of raw mango. I think it's grated and then...
Yes.
So we're going to taste this with the...
Allam chutney.
The allam chutney. You know, if I were to put in the equivalent of what you guys understand best here is Tollywood, it's like two superstars coming together,
yes,
right?
It's a multi-star.
We had a 70mm at the beginning, and to end we have this mango uthappam with that allam chutney. Robust flavors, big flavors on both sides, and that's what you really taste. I'm going to wrap up
with the sweet chutney.
With the sweet chutney. I love this chutney. bite of a mango uthappam with the kobari palu. And the last bite of the chutney here at Chutneys. It's been such a fantastic experience here, tasting the Andhra flavors for breakfast here at Chutneys. So the food has been outstanding. I think each one of the dishes, I think that Babai Idli, I can still remember that soft, luscious butteriness on my palate.
Yes.
And each one of the dishes has been outstanding. But I think what has really made this special is the fact that we are collaborating here with Ravi. And I think our experience here of breakfast has probably multiplied many fold just because he's sitting here on the table and walking us through the dishes, taking us through the nuances of what makes a breakfast here special. This is our first collab. We've got another collab video coming up as well. You've got to look out for that shortly. But I'm hoping this is the first, the second of many more such episodes to come. So thank you very much,
Ravi.
It's been fantastic to meet you and share breakfast with you. Until the next one, stay safe and happy
eating.
Happy eating.
Yes.
If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, share and leave a comment. If you'd like to support Food Lovers TV, do log on to foodlovers.in and hit the support Food Lovers banner. Links in the description below. Happy eating.